Okay, Cody, here we go, mate. Just doing a quick video for you. Just got a bit of sand here. I've got from my mate to creek out at Dabra. And I've got some in the pan here. This is my little Garrett one. I've just got some of that sand in there, right? Now, here's my three little bits of lead shot that I've made. Just some split shot cut in half. Got three little bits there, right? Three bits, throw them into there, and away we go. Stratisfy. Round and round, side to side, give it a good old shake. Get those heavy to the bottom. You can see I've got those riffles away from me there, because I'm going to be panning them that way. So give it a good shake. Last little shake, just shake a little bit as you're tipping it, but don't let the material go over the end. See how I stopped it before then? And all you do is put the pan in and lift it up. You'll see the material come out. Three or four of them. Back down. Plenty of water. Give it a good shake. Side to side, slow down. Little shake. Just down. Sort of just lift it. Just like that. See, you put it down in the water. Just lift. See how the material comes off you? Watch. Material come off. So just do it like that. Back down. Back down in that corner. You want to get right down into this corner down there. One of these corners. That's where you want to go. That's what you're aiming for. Back down level. Shake, shake, shake. Side to side, tilt it a bit, stop, wash off the lights. Don't have to force anything. Let it wash off. Back down, a bit more water. Back down to the bottom there. And we'll just grab it a bit different. Shake, shake, shake. Just a little shake like that. We're getting down low now. These riffles are good in these Garrett pans, because they're nice deep riffles, as you can see. See that? So the material stays in there. This is the smaller one. This is called the Garrett. I don't know if you can see it. Garrett. Gravity trap, it's called. Plus I've got the big one, the super sluice. Back down. Shake. Stop, a bit more of a wash. You could see my lead down the bottom already, right? So you know you're doing the right thing. Back down. Might have some gold in this because this is stuff that I've classified from my mate's dry creek. I've moved it around now, you can see, to the smoother side because I'm down to a little bit. Material. So I want to just gently work this. Always have lots of water. Give it a good shake down in that corner. Now here, you can go a bit slower. See how I could just bring the water up and just gently wash that off. Or you can do this motion. Waving it off. You watch how it waves off. See that? Nice and clean. Back down again. Little shake. Tilt it a bit to get it down into that corner. And you can do it. As you're doing this, just watch for any colours. The gold will usually come up around here, towards the back. You talk to all the experts and I'll say, don't watch the front. Don't watch the front here, watch the back when you're washing. A bit more of a shake. You can hear the bits of split shot. A bit more of a wash. This wash in action for the light, it gets it off nicely. I can control it how I want. You can see black sand turning up. Look at that. right down. This is why I like practicing. You can practice right down. Wash that last little bit off. We're down to our last little bit. And now we can do a bit of a wash around. When I wash around, I shake. Helps bring... Hang on, I'm just repositioning. It helps to bring that material down. You see, I've got my three bits of shot there. Bit of black sand. There's a bit of gold there. Hang on, I'll take these out. I'll show you the bit of gold and we'll separate it. Actually, there's a couple of bits. So I'll take these out. I know I've got my shot in there. When you take bits of rock out, make sure it's in a bit of water. Just give them a little dunk. Make sure there's no gold on them. And there's those bits. Put them down to the side. Now, I could see a bit of gold here somewhere. This is going to be hard. This is where you can do the tap motion. Make sure the water's in there. And you tap it. You see all the heavies going up here? And if you look there, a little speck here somewhere. It's hard to see. There's a little speck up in there. If you can keep the little ones, you know you're panning right. So wash off again. No, he's floating. I think. There he is. Where is he? Right there. It's hard to see. Camera's got a bit of dirt on it. I'll see if I can. Really hard doing this one handed. He's just there. Oh, because as soon as you move this bowl of little ones, they just go away. Hang on, I'll see if I can get these down again. Hang on. I'll try and get this gold. I could see it. It's only little stuff. Good for practice. Because I can't tap and do this, which I usually do, there's a little bit right there. Don't know if you can see it. It's very small. I can't see it through the viewfinder. Anyway. So small, I don't think it's picking it up. Even with the water on it. Anyway, that's how you do it. One day when I get set up where I can have a stand, I'll be able to do this a little better. So you can just swirl it around a little bit in water. A little bit, but I can't keep them up there and tap because I'm holding this camera. I'll just see a little bit just floated down just about there. There's another bit just there. Some more bits up there. So there's some gold in my mate's dirt, so that's good. I'll clean this up and do another one. I'll catch you later, mate.